This episode is brought to you by Skillshare. The first 1,000 people to sign up using the link in the description will get their first 2 months free. Before a medical drug makes its way into the market, it has to go through various stages of testing. This starts with a laboratory investigation, which might begin with lab-grown human cells and computer models. If the drug passes that test, then scientists move on to animal testing. If the drug gets the green light again, we bring in the humans. The drugs are tested on people in what we call clinical trials or drug studies. These trials might include healthy people or sick people. They can test a drug's effectiveness, side effects, or how the body absorbs it, bioavailability. The drug should already be safe, but there have been times that things went horribly wrong. That's what we'll talk about today in this episode of the Infographics Show, medical drug trials that turned into living nightmares. Before we get to the horror, let's first paint a picture of what medical trial might look like. They don't always create elephant men, our last and most disturbing tale on this list. Let's say you're testing for bioavailability. Generally, you'll apply to do the test and then be asked to come in for an interview and some checks. If you pass, you're given a date and location where the study will take place. You'll likely be asked to fast just before you come in, not take drugs, including alcohol, and possibly even grapefruit juice. All trials are different, but one man told us when he did trials in Montreal, Canada, that he would turn up to a center and then was told he would be a number as well as a name. He fondly remembers being number 17 during one trial. He said the center had a pool table, rooms with bunk beds, TVs, and game consoles. There were also books and magazines to read. Everyone had to eat the same food and finish the meal. All participants ate according to their number, and that's why everyone wanted to be number one. After a while, he said everyone is peeing and pooing almost in line with their numbers. You can leave the study, but you won't usually get paid. He said being confined with other snoring, not always nice men can be challenging, and on his trials at least one day involving having 20 plus blood draws. If you don't have a catheter, this can turn your arms black and blue. Many of the people were jobless and desperate. Some were musicians or writers, and others were actually medical students from Montreal's universities, he said. He got about $200 a day, and the longest trial he did was two separate runs of 5 days. So it's not a bad paycheck for doing nothing but playing games and reading. No one in his trial had a bad reaction to the drug, although he said there were heated arguments at times over the TV channel, or someone's loud snoring, and some people fainted during the blood draws. Okay, so you get the picture. We'll start with some lighter stories and finish with 2006's horror trial that shook the world. All these are fairly recent cases, but going back to the past, we could certainly dig up some shocking tales, such as the testing of the drug thalidomide. If it kills monkeys. This recent trial that went wrong took place in France in 2006. It was so bad that the European Union decided it was time to create new laws that protected volunteers. The trial was said to have been bungled, and it led to the death of one man and brain damage of 4 more. A company called BioTrial was testing a compound called BIA-102474 that was being tested to cure a number of diseases. The volunteers at the trial at first did not suffer any serious side effects, but when their dose was increased, volunteer 2508 said his vision went blurry and he had headaches. "We expected to see him come back," said one of the staff, so the trial continued. The man, a 49-year-old artist, was declared brain dead the next day. As for 3 of the 4 others that were sick, a doctor later said that even in the best situation, there will be an irreversible handicap. The payment was around $2,200 for 2 weeks. An investigation later revealed that several monkeys had died during pre-human testing, but this information was not in the study protocol report. Drug blindness. This story involves women taking part in a drug trial to improve eyesight. What happened was exactly the opposite. They lost their sight. The Independent in the UK called the 2017 drug trial botched. It certainly was. The US patients even had to pay $5,000 to take part. They were testing stem cell treatments to improve their eyesight as the aged women suffered from something called macular degeneration that can make some objects look blurry. They're now totally blind and unlikely to recover, an associate professor of clinical ophthalmology at the University of Miami told The Independent. Reports suggest the study was a kind of Wild West trial, with some experts saying it wasn't even founded on scientific evidence. The Independent writes the treatment involves combining fat tissue removed from the patient's abdomens with enzymes to obtain adipose-derived stem cells. That was mixed with blood and injected into the women's eyes. But the drug was injected into both eyes at once, which is a very fundamental mistake. They might have only lost one eye's sight had the test been done right. In all, the study was kind of a Dr. Frankenstein experiment according to experts, and the women now see nothing at all. Enlarged brains. This terrible tale happened in 2016, when 5 people died after testing a medicine called chimeric antigen receptor, CART, in the USA. The treatment was seen as possibly a miracle cure, which consisted of adding extra disease-fighting protein to a person's immune cells. All the people in the trial had leukemia and were hoping to be cured. The treatment was seen as a great breakthrough in medicine and even won prizes, but things went wrong during one trial. The company doing the trial admitted that an internal investigation revealed the patients had died due to severe cerebral edema. The worst thing is, the trial continued as they thought they knew what had caused this brain swelling. And then, in a subsequent trial, more people died. CART therapy is still seen as a possible cure for cancer, although in 2017, during a French trial, we were told one patient died from multiple organ failure, probably triggered by neutropenic sepsis at day 15. We should add here that hundreds of people die each year in drug trials in the US and UK, thousands in India, but many of those people are already on death's door. That's certainly not always the case though, as you'll see. Pocket money. 19-year-old student Nicole Wan was a healthy young girl who took part in a medical trial in 1996 to earn a bit of extra cash to pay the bills and have some fun. She would have got $150 for taking part in a trial at the University of Rochester Medical Center in New York State. The New York Times wrote that the researchers had violated their own guidelines by giving the girl an increased amount of anesthetic lidocaine. The test was to see what effect pollution had on her respiratory system, and that involved having a tube inserted into her lungs. For that, you must have a local anesthetic, as without it, it would be mightily uncomfortable. The Times wrote at the time, "She never told her parents, a restaurant worker and a seamstress who are immigrants from Hong Kong and live in Queens." Because she was given so much anesthetic, after the study the young woman started to feel weak and had a lot of pain. 2 days later, her heart stopped and she died. She was coughing and having difficulty, the doctor told the Times. "So they kept spritzing more lidocaine down her throat," he said. Reports also state the girl had not known exactly the kind of test she would be going through. The Elephant Man Trial. Finally, we come to perhaps the scariest story in drug study history, what we know about anyway. It happened in the UK in 2006 at London's Northwick Park Hospital. 8 very healthy young men would be given an experimental immune system drug called TGN-1412 for the treatment of leukemia. After taking the drugs, things turned very dark for 6 of them. 2 lucky others took the placebos. The story sounds like something from a horror movie. It was all manic, everything was happening all at once. They were vomiting, they were screaming in pain, people fainting, said one BBC documentary on the disaster. As the men's organs failed and their temperatures rocketed, their bodies also swelled in the extreme. Some reports say their heads almost doubled in size, hence Elephant Man trial. No one knew what happened. This was a mystery. We had no way of predicting how severe it was going to get. There was no rule book for how to deal with this, one doctor later said. One man told The Guardian, "I started shouting, 'Doctor, this pain is killing me, do something.'" He recalled the placebo takers were happily reading books, although some reports say they were later horrified by what they saw. The Guardian writes that one man suffered heart, liver, and kidney failure, pneumonia, septicemia, and frostbite-like symptoms that resulted in his toes and sections of his feet being amputated and several fingertips falling off. They were all rushed to intensive care, and the trial was declared by police a crime scene. Amazingly, they all survived, but what happened to them may mean they don't live long lives. They're all still alive today, though. We imagine they got their $2,500 for the trial, and at least one of them claimed millions in compensation. Although one medical website writes, "The long-term effects on their immune systems remain unknown, though on discharge some were warned they may suffer an increased risk of cancers and autoimmune diseases." A bit of advice if you're going to do a drug trial. Be sure to do your research. Is the drug new? Are you the first to test it? That's a matter of importance. You definitely don't want to end up needing to rely on dangerous drug trials to make ends meet. So why not learn some new life and work skills with Skillshare and beef that resume up? With over 20,000 classes hosted online, Skillshare is your one-stop shop for learning everything from management skills to graphic design. Get better at your current job or learn the skills to land a completely new one. The first 1,000 people to visit the link in the description will receive premium membership for 2 months, completely free. Join Skillshare and start learning today. After hearing this, would you take part in a medical drug trial? Have you already done one? What was it like? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, A Day in the Life of North Korean Dictator Kim Jong-un. Thanks for watching, and as always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.